This video will explore the ways in which we incorporated the elements of Ginsberg's style into our own rewrite of Goldilocks and the Three Bears. The first way in which we did this was through first-person narration, which can be seen in Ginsberg's poem, A Supermarket in California, where he narrates the poem as if he's standing right next to Walt Whitman as he's walking down the aisles of the supermarket. We do this in Goldilocks by repeating the phrase, I saw you, as we describe her actions from the beginning of her journey in the forest, through the halls of the bear's home, and lastly, as she exits into the forest again. We do this again when we use the sentence, I stand watched by the entryway, to emphasize that we are placing the narrator in the scene when the bears return home. A second element of Ginsberg's style we used was the anti-capitalist sentiment that was present in many of his poems. We do this mainly through contrasting the forest, where Goldilocks begins, with the home of the bears, which we want to describe as extremely wealthy. And we do this by describing their door as gilded with gold, which paints the image that they are very well off. We also reference Uncle Sam, who is a traditional symbol of American capitalism, in the context of Goldilocks being dwarfed by many of the consumer items that we can find in the bear's home, such as the hot bowls of porridge and the very large chairs. Lastly, we used many instances of alliteration, which can be seen in Ginsberg's poems. We do this in Goldilocks by using the phrase gold, gilded gate, and grain, gluten, gluttony. The word gluttony adds on to the anti-capitalist sentiment, since we're basically describing that the bears are very wasteful and have a lot more than they need.